السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، my brothers and sisters, in this next video, inshallah, I will be talking to you about the rights of the parents and the children. Now, as we know, both the parents and the children have rights that need to be fulfilled. So, first, let's talk about the rights of the parents, since that's highlighted a lot. So the rights of the parents that have to be fulfilled are that the children have to be obedient to the parents and they have to show them kindness. Now, obedience, some people get confused on. They get confused on what obedience really is. You know, some people think obedience is, you know, I have to do everything that my parents tell me, you know. Some people, what if it isn't in the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, what if it's a sin they're asking me to do? And you know, what you have, now this is where respect comes into play. Now, respect means that you do not raise your voice to them, you know. You don't roll your eyes at them. You don't curse at them. You know, it says in the Quran that the children shouldn't say anything more than uff. You know, uff. Nothing more than uff to their parents. And, you know, nowadays you find kids not respecting their parents, sometimes even controlling them. Obedience means that if they tell you something to do and is not disrespectful to Allah and it's not a sin, then go ahead and do it. But if it is, then do not shout at them saying, don't you know what is haram? Astaghfirullah. Why are you asking me to do this? What's wrong with you? No, that will only decrease their chances of accepting Islam. Because the biggest dawah is your character. That's the biggest dawah. Because you never know what small deed you do, and then somebody could convert to Islam. So you never know. So, you know, this is why the Muslims should generally have a better character. You know, what do you have to say? What do you say if, like, they're asking you to do something that's wrong? You say, Mom, I can't. Dad, I'm sorry, I can't do this. You know, it's forbidden for me. And if they get angry at you, then, you know, just leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bear patience. And you notice a lot of this stuff happens to, you know, new reverts and converts. So, inshallah, may Allah grant them steadfastness and may He grant them sabr. You know, forgive me if I keep clearing my throat. I have a bit of a scratchy throat. Not scratchy throat. I have a bit of a cold, so forgive me if I keep... forgive me when I keep clearing my throat. The Prophet ﷺ said that the parents of a person are his Jannah and Jahannam. So what does this mean? My parents are Jannah and Jahannam. Okay, so what this means? A person who is kind, obedient, respectful, and he's attending to the needs of his parents, and he's fulfilling the rights of his parents, this will be, you know, his, you know, entry into Jannah. He will get Jannah. But if he is rude, he is disobedient, he is ignorant, he is arrogant, then he shall have hell. May Allah Azza wa Jalla protect us from hell, you know, not letting us go there for a second, a minute, a day, not for any time at all, and may He make us amongst those who enter Jannah in the first groups. Now, the rights of the children. The children have their right, they have the right to be fed, you know, fed food, to be educated, to get, you know, some knowledge, and protected until the point of adulthood when they can protect themselves. Now, it's the job for the parents to construct this child's personality in the best way. You know, start with yourself. The way you act is the way your child is most likely going to act. So, you know, for example, if you curse a lot, then your child is most likely going to curse. If you talk back to your parents, then your child's most likely gonna do that to you. Excuse me. So parents must teach their children about Islam and its rules and its etiquettes, and teach them good things, and make sure, you know, not to be hypocritical, because you know, like, say, okay, around my child, I'm gonna, you know, do good things. I'm gonna recite Quran, I'm gonna talk good, I'm gonna try my best not to do any sin. And yet behind closed doors, you know, the person's doing sin, the person's talking foul mouth, person's backbiting. You know, don't be hypocritical. Don't be. Because you never know when people will find out what you've been doing. And being a hypocrite is a really, really big sin. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from ever becoming hypocrites. And probably the most important one of all, in my opinion, is love. This is what children live for. They need to be loved, kissed, hugged, and encouraged. They live for this. They live for the parents' approval. They want to see the parents proud of them. See, here, you know, their parents say, hey, good job. You're doing good. Keep it up. Keep it going. You know, they want to hear that. They live for the parents' approval. That's what the child lives for, literally. Lives for their parents' approval. And if they don't get it, they're disappointed. They keep trying. Until eventually, they get it. You know, somewhere along the line, inshallah, the child gets it. So, you know, and for parents, you know, appreciate whatever little the child is doing. Because, you know, if the child is doing very little good, he's doing a lot of bad, at least, you know, look at the good side and appreciate the good side and compliment him on his good side, compliment the child on the good side. And you never know, inshallah ta'ala, this child may, you know, do more good. You know why? Because you encourage this child to keep going. Keep going. You say, oh, you're a very nice person. You always like to help me out. You're a very good son. You like to help me with, you know, let's say, cooking. You like to help me with cooking. You're a good daughter. You like to help me with cooking. You like to help me with, you know, cleaning up. The son, you know, likes to, you know, when his mother is having a hard time, you know, doing something all by herself, you know, and she asks him, you know, to help her out. He goes and helps her. And the son may be doing a lot of bad things, but when she keeps, you know, complimenting him on it and inspiring him, you know, and he feels, you know, I have this good quality in me. I feel like such a good person. So then he says, okay, I want to do more. So then he keeps going and keeps going until he gets more good qualities. You know, inshallah ta'ala, you know, I hope that we can all be good to our parents. And, you know, we can fulfill the rights of our parents and let our parents be the way to Jannah for us and not the way to Jahannam for us. You know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease the burdens of those who are suffering around the world, and may He make the tests for everybody, for all of us, easy, and may He not let us go astray, and may He make us amongst those who go to Jannah in the first groups. May He make us amongst those who get their books in their right hand. Excuse me. And may He make us amongst those who go across the Sirat and do not slip off the Sirat. May He make us amongst those who are glowing with Nur on that day. May He make us amongst those who perform the Salah. Inshallah, you know, I mean, I hope you all have benefited from this video. And inshallah ta'ala, if you could please, you know, share this with your friends and your family so this way that they can benefit from this as well. Inshallah ta'ala, until I see you all next time. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.